Wouldn't even know.
Yeah.
Cards and cats, so.
I'll start. The website I write for is brazenwomen.com. So for you two ladies, what does being brazen mean to you? Brazen?
Brazen.
Start with the tough ones.
Well, like, give us the dictionary definition.
What is brazen?
Yeah, let's actually go
and outspoken. Outgoing. Okay,
and outspoken.
I didn't know that.
Veronica's incredibly outspoken.
Think of feminist.
I don't think Veronica's capable of not being outspoken.
Yeah, and I think Betty's.
Oh, I'm relating it to the show immediately. I'm so used to that.
What does that mean?
Oh, is that? Yeah, right.
Yeah. But you have brazen
character. Being strong and being bold and not taking shit.
Not taking shit.
Not letting people walk all over you. You know, standing up for yourself and speaking out when you feel like something is wrong. And not, you know, being afraid to be bold. You know, I think a lot of women think that the second they stand out for them, stand up for themselves, they're a bitch.
Yeah.
And that's so not true. It's a very bold way of looking at things. And I think it's a matter of ignoring that and saying what you feel anyways. To act out of love for yourself. Rather than fear.
So, speaking of being brazen, Darker Betty, Marina's here.
Brazen Betty.
You know, honestly, season two I feel like is less of a Dark Betty situation and more of a tortured soul Betty, for very different reasons. I think in season one, her darkness came from her kind of anxiety being built up and her being like suppressing it because her mom wasn't acknowledging it and just her environment. But season two is more of a not so much anxiety, but just her circumstances overwhelm her. And gosh, I can't say much, but the mystery in season two really takes its toll and kind of is centered on Betty.
Yeah. It sounds like it'd be that way of Veronica as well, because her dad.
Oh my gosh, her dad. First of all, I love Mark and Spanish. He's blending into the family so well. And what's really terrifying is Hermione and Hiram together. Like, they are like Frank and Claire Underwood in season two. And at first, Veronica's suspicious, and then at one point, she kind of tries to be a part of it. She's like, involve me. Like, let's keep an open relationship so that we all know what's going on. I want to be in on this. But they're keeping that wall, and Veronica's trying to, like, break it down, and it's not really working out.
Quickly, let's speak about the boys. So Jughead, he's out of the area at the moment. He's on the other side of town. So how is that for Betty?
I mean, season two in general is kind of like a split between the north side and the south side, and so obviously that's going to affect Betty and Jughead's relationship. Seeing as he's going to a different high school now, and, you know, kind of a, it's not a long-distance relationship, but them being at separate schools at such a young age and going through such completely different family drama and just every day-to-day circumstances, it takes its toll on them. It becomes kind of like a Romeo and Juliet situation. Just pray for Becca. Pray for Becca.
How about Archie and Veronica, though?
Are we good?
Yeah.
Just,
I'm sorry.
Oh, it's okay.